Mr. Min Woong-gi, Chairman of Nami Island. Mr. Lee Ge-yong, Vice Chairman of Nami Island. Mr. Min Kyong-hyuk, CEO of Nami Island. Mr. Fred Min, CEO of the Nami Island Arts and Education Incorporated. Mr. John Jin-pyo, Deputy Mayor of Chuncheon City. Mr. Kim Kuthe, DG of Economic and Industry Bureau of Gapyeong-gun. Professor Kim Chan-wan of Hoofs. Ms. Park Yo-song, Director of Indian Art Museum in Yongwol. All other friends joining us here today, a very good morning to all of you. I'll welcome you to the launch of the 7th edition of Sarang, the Festival of India in the Republic of Korea, that has been organized every year by the Embassy of India and Cultural Center in Seoul. We're very pleased to be partnering with the Nami Island Arts and Education in this launch event today. We're happy to see the participation by other cultural organizations, both from India and from Korea, in the festival this year. Friends, this festival has been organized annually as a endeavor to introduce various facets of Indian dance, music, film, cuisine, and art to the people of Korea. We have partnered with various Korean organizations as well as Indian organizations to bring the best of Indian culture to the people of Korea, not only in Seoul, but all over the country. We have succeeded to a great extent in this effort, and Sarang has now become a much looked forward to event in the Korean cultural calendar. Normally, our event extends for over a month, usually in the month of September or October, and travels to different cities in Korea. Given the kind of travel restrictions that are in place right now, and the restrictions on social gathering due to the challenges of the COVID-19 outbreak, we are organizing our festival, or at least the launch of our festival this year in hybrid mode. I'm delighted to be able to bring the launch of the 7th edition of Sarang in the beautiful island of Nami. Celebrations this year are especially special because of the fact that this is coinciding with our India at 75 celebrations, or Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, which marked the 75th anniversary of India's independence from colonial rule. We will be celebrating this milestone anniversary through various events, including international conferences, lectures and workshops, cultural events, including visual art performances, film shows, yoga demonstrations and workshops, Buddhist events, art competitions, and so on. The Indian Cultural Center in Seoul is organizing a series of events in partnership with local organizations to mark this joyous occasion, with a special focus on themes that are of relevance to the India-ROK relationship. Friends, we chose the name Sarang as the theme of our festival, or the hallmark of our festival, as this has a very deep meaning both in the Korean and the Indian languages. Sarang in Korean means love, and for Indians it refers to diversity representing the colors of India. As part of this festival, we try to showcase the rich cultural diversity of India represented through various art forms including dance, drama, music, films and cuisine. The depiction of our diversity captures the hearts and minds of the local community, our friends of India in Korea, and strengthens the love and friendship between our peoples. During these challenging times, we hope that this cultural extravaganza will help us to reconnect with nature for rejuvenating our minds, bodies, and souls, while at the same time keeping alive the cultural connections between the people of India and the people of Korea. Through our cooperation with our friends in Naminara, we are able to bring glimpses of our culture to the visitors to Nami, and in turn inform the people of India of this beautiful and picturesque island, which has something for everyone. Naminara eso Sarangul manna boseyo. I take this opportunity to welcome you all again to Sarang 2021. Kamsam nida, dhanyavad, namaste.